Hi folks, this is Odefrut. I'm in Heidelberg, Germany, and this slope here, it's called Steinach, traditionally Stonich, which means stony, has been used for growing wine for well over 1,000 years, for like about 1,200 and some years, since the time before Charlemagne, before the creation of such nations like Germany, France, Russia, Spain, Britain. Yeah, this little piece of land has been used for wine growing, and this is this has been recorded as a vine, well, as a vineyard slope, as a slope with vineyards. And some of the grapevines here, well, they are not 1,000 years old, but a lot of those old ones are well over 100 years old. Yeah, in this area, well, not just on this slope, but also on other slopes in the area, you can actually see a lot of traces of old, small-scale vineyards from like the end of the 19th century or the first decades of the 20th century. And those grapevines here have been estimated to be a bit over 100 years old. This variety is the Trollinger. Well, it sounds like a troll, but actually the name comes from Tirol or Tyrol, an area, well, in the southern part of the Alps, which used to be Austrian, but now is Italian, at least the southern part where this type of grape comes from. Yeah, it has been brought to Germany like about 500 years ago, and is very typical for Württemberg, for the wine growing area of Württemberg, which is an area to the east of here. Here we are officially in the wine growing area of Baden, Badische Weinstraße, where it's still grown to some extent. It's been losing to more modern grape varieties in recent decades. But yeah, here in this, on those historical vineyards, it's not so much about the most modern and most productive grapevines, but also about preserving old historical varieties. Now let's try this Trollinger or Tirolinger. Nice and sweet. Very good. A problem with those old Trollinger types is that they don't ripen, that not all berries ripen, and so a lot of modern vineyards try not to grow them because basically they have to throw away part of the grapes. Well, in small scale old-fashioned wine production, you can basically pick out the ripe berries and leave the others, but those old Trollinger varieties are not so popular with modern large-scale vineyards. So folks, this was the Trollinger, an ancient over 100-year-old grapevine in a vineyard which is well over 1,000 years old. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the beautiful city of Heidelberg with its nice view. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.